rising curve at him, and serve was way out ahead of it. Padres leading with Roy Campanella. Now the conference is broken up. Campy comes stomping back behind the plate. Padres goes back to the mound. Scourin, who doubled here in the second with two down, is the base runner at second, making the lead. Outfield fanned around the left and playing deep. The serve can clout that ball if he gets a hold of it. Padres peers down, takes the 0-2 sign. Checks his runner, fires away at the plate. A curveball swung on, hit down to shortstop. Reese up with it, throws to first in time, and that's all in the second inning. Serve goes down. So in the second, no runs. One base hit, a double by Skyron. One man was left on, there were no errors. Score at the end of two innings of play now. It's Yankees nothing and Brooklyn nothing. Tommy Byrne comes to the mound now to start the third inning. He'll pitch to Zimmer, Padres, and Gilliam in that order. But before we get started, let's quickly pause for station identification. This is Mutual, the radio network for all America. Second baseman Don Zimmer coming up to the plate for his first at-bat of the afternoon, hitting number 8 in the Brooklyn order. He's had 2 base hits and 7 tries in the series, has driven in 2 runs, and he's batting at .286. Little right-hand hitter who holds a heavy bat way down to the end. He'll be followed by Johnny Padres, the pitcher, and then we'll go to the top of the batting order for Jim Gilliam. A scoreless duel here. We've had only 1 base hit in the entire game. The Yankees picked it up on Moose Karin's double in the second. So Tommy Byrne gets ready now to begin inning number 3. Byrne sets, fires it in there, and the pitcher swung on, dragged across the carpet to short. Rizzuto off to his left, up with it, makes the throw to first in plenty of time, and Zimmer is out. One away, top of the third. Johnny Padres in the World Series this year has had 1 hit in 3 at-bats. So he's batting at .333. Johnny Padres getting the round of applause he richly deserves. Both of these pitchers have been old man ice water and old man tough this afternoon, right up to this minute. Padres standing in, about as deep in batter's box as law will allow. Bends over, Byrne throws him the slider and gets it in there for a strike. No balls, 1 strike. 1 out, nobody on, top of the third, no score. Byrne pumps, delivers, fastball, swung on and missed for strike 2. Byrne working right back to Padres on the 0-2 count, throws a curveball, it's popped right back here by our cameras, right off to the left of it. Somebody almost got that one. Here at the series this year, we share a booth with a television camera. We've been talking to it right along, but the thing never answers us back. The 0-2 delivery now to Johnny Padres. Byrne is ready. So is Yogi Berra. 1 out, nobody on, top of the third. Overhand curveball, slammed down to the right side on 2 big hops. Billy Martin makes the play on it, goes first, and that's all for Padres. 2 men up, 2 men quietly down in the third inning. Jim Gilliam rolled out to shortstop to begin things for the Dodgers in the first inning, so he's making his second appearance. 6-for-21 in the series. Against the left-hand offerings of Tommy Byrne, of course, Gilliam is batting right-handed. Old Casey Stengel down there, pacing back and forth in the Yankees dugout. Byrne delivers a soft curveball, and Gilliam takes low for ball 1. Some of the pictures that have been taken and printed of Casey Stengel's meanderings in the dugout have been something. Fastball tried on Gilliam and it's shoulder high outside for ball two. You ought to hear old Case lecture to his boys, too. Oh, me. Burns sets, looks at Gilliam, comes down to him on the 2-0 count, misses with a fastball outside, and that's ball three. So a two down, Gilliam has gotten ahead of Byrne on a 3-0 count. No score in this one so far. Byrne delivers 3-0. His pitch is low outside for ball four. That's the second walk given up for the Deacon. Well, the Dodgers find themselves with their second base runner. Byrne did the same thing after getting Campanella and Perillo. He walked Hodges, then Hope rolled out behind. Hodges to retire the side. The batter now is Pee Wee Reese. Reese flied to center field in the first inning to Bob serve. So Pee Wee's 0 for 1. Byrne back to visit the rosin bag. Comes up to the mound now. Looks over at Gilliam, who's a pretty good base runner. Scarron, the first baseman, holds the inside corner on Jim. Descoli's the umpire there to call the play. Pitch to the plate is taken outside by Reese for ball one. Burn to the top of the stretch again with a check of the runner. And a pitch to the plate to Reese. And he lays it in there for a called first strike. Reese takes a check at third. See what Billy Harmon has on the way of signs. This is the Dodgers' outstanding hit-and-run combination. Get him on and Reese up the plate. 1-1 count. There's the pitch. Over to Reese for strike two. Byrne came along with a medium speed curveball. Reese didn't even offer to pull the trigger. Gilliam leads off first now with hands on hips. Now he leans over, puts his hands on his knees. Pitch to Reese is swung on. Hit foul off to the right of the plate. The crowd out of play and the count holds at 1-2. No score in the ball game. We're in the top of the third inning. Two down for the Dodgers. They have a base runner in Gilliam at first base. The Yankees have had only one base runner. That's when Scarron doubled with two out the last half of last inning. He remained at second when Sir rolled out behind him from short first. So both of these pitchers are letting out just a little bit more this afternoon. Byrne is set now with Barry Smith as a target. The 1-2 delivery to Pee Wee Reese. Fastball swung on. Hit out in the center field. Bob serve off to his right. Takes the line drive to retire the side. So a Dodger threat again goes for the board. No runs with no base hits. Potter set him up with a fastball and then fired that slow tantalizing curve at him and serve was way out ahead of it. Andres leading with Roy Campanella. Now the conference is broken up. Campy comes stomping back behind the plate. Padres goes back to the mound. Scarron, who doubled here in the second with two down, is the base runner at second, making the lead. Outfield fanned around the left and playing deep. The serve can pelt that ball if he gets a hold of it. Padres peers down, takes the 0-2 sign. Checks his runner, fires away at the plate, a curveball, swung on, hit down to shortstop. Reese up with it, throws to first in time, and that's all in the second inning. The serve goes down. So in the second, no runs, one base hit, a double by Scarron. One man was left on, there were no errors. Score at the end of two innings of play now. It's Yankees nothing and Brooklyn nothing. Tommy Byrne comes to the mound now to start the third inning. He'll pitch to Zimmer, Padres, and Gilliam in that order. But before we get started, let's quickly pause for station identification. This is Mutual, the radio network for all America. Second baseman Don Zimmer coming up to the plate for his first at-bat of the afternoon, hitting number 8 in the Brooklyn order. He's had 2 base hits and 7 tries in the series, has driven in 2 runs, and he's batting at 286. Little right-hand hitter who holds a heavy bat way down to the end. He'll be followed by Johnny Podras, the pitcher, and then we'll go to the top of the batting order for Jim Gilliam. A scoreless duel here. We've had only 1 base hit in the entire game. The Yankees picked it up on Moose Garin's double in the second. So Tommy Byrne gets ready now to begin inning number 3. Byrne sets, fires it in there, and the pitch is swung on, dragged across the carpet to short. Rizzuto off to his left, up with it, makes the throw to first in plenty of time, and Zimmer is out. One away, top of the third. Johnny Podras in the World Series this year has had 1 hit in 3 at-bats. So he's batting at 333. Johnny Podras getting the round of applause he richly deserves. Both of these pitchers have been old man ice water and old man tough this afternoon, right up to this minute. Podras standing in, about as deep in batter's box as law will allow. Bends over. Byrne throws him the slider and gets it in there for a strike. No balls, 1 strike. 1 out, nobody on, top of the third, no score. Byrne pumps, delivers, fastball, swung on and missed for strike 2. Byrne working right back to Podras on the 0-2 count, throws a curveball, it's popped right back here by our cameras, right off to the left of us. Somebody almost got that one. Here at the series this year, we share a booth with a television camera. We've been talking to it right along, but the thing never answers us back. The 0-2 delivery now to Johnny Podras. Byrne is ready. So is Yogi Berra. 1 out, nobody on, top of the third. Overhand curveball, slammed down to the right side on 2 big hops. Billy Martin makes the play on it. Goes to first, and that's all for Podras. 2 men up, 2 men quietly down in the third inning. Jim Gilliam rolled out to shortstop to begin things for the Dodgers in the first inning, so he's making his second appearance. 6-for-21 in the series. Against the left-hand offerings of Tommy Byrne, of course, Gilliam is batting right-handed. Old Casey Stengel down there, pacing back and forth in the Yankees dugout. Byrne delivers a soft curveball, and Gilliam takes low for ball 1. Some of the pictures that have been taken and printed of Casey Stengel's meanderings in the dugout have been something. Fastball, stride on Gilliam, and it's shoulder high outside for ball 2. You ought to hear old Case lecture to his boys, too. Oh, me. Byrne sets, looks at Gilliam, comes down to him on the 2-0 count, misses with a fastball outside, and that's ball 3. So a 2 down, Gilliam has gotten ahead of Byrne on a 3-0 count. No score in this one so far. Byrne delivers 3-0. His pitch is low outside for ball four. That's second walk given up for the Deacon. So the Dodgers find themselves with their second base runner. Byrne did the same thing after getting Campanella and Perillo. He walked Hodges, then Hope rolled out behind. Hodges to retire the side. The batter now is Pee Wee Reese. Reese flied to center field in the first inning to Bob serve. So Pee Wee's 0 for 1. Byrne back to visit the rosin bag. Comes up to the mound now. Looks over at Gilliam, who's a pretty good base runner. Scarring, the first baseman, holds the inside corner on Jim. Descoli's umpire there to call the play. Pitch to the plate is taken outside by Reese for ball one. Top of the stretch again with a check of the runner and a pitch to the plate to Reese, and he lays it in there for a calm first strike. Reese takes a check at third. See what Billy Harmon has on the way of signs. This is the Dodgers' outstanding hit and run combination. Get him on, and Reese up the plate. 1-1 count. There's the pitch. Over to Reese for strike two. Byrne came along with a medium speed curveball. Reese didn't even offer to pull the trigger. Gilliam leads off at first now with hands on hips. Now he leans over, puts his hands on his knees. The pitch to Reese is swung on. Foul off to the right of the plate to the crowd out of play, and the count holds at 1-2. No score in the ball game. We're in the top of the third inning. Two down for the Dodgers. They have a base runner in Gilliam at first base. The Yankees have had only one base runner. That's when Skarin doubled with two out the last half of last inning. He remained at second when serve rolled out behind him from short first. So both of these pitchers are letting out just a little bit more this afternoon. Byrne is set now with Barry Smith as a target. The 1-2 delivery to Pee Wee Reese. Fastball swung on, hit out in center field. Bob serve off to his right, takes the line drive to retire the side. So a Dodger threat again goes for the board. No runs with no base hits. Set him up with a fastball and then fired that slow, tantalizing curve at him, and serve was way out ahead of it. Padres leading with Roy Campanella. Now the conference is broken up. Campy comes stomping back behind the plate. Padres goes back to the mound. Scourin, who doubled here in the second with two down, is the base runner at second, making the lead. Outfield fanned around the left and playing deep. The serve can pelt that ball if he gets a hold of it. Padres peers down, takes the 0-2 sign. Checks his runner, fires away at the plate. A curveball swung on, hit down to shortstop. Reese up with it, throws to first in time, and that's all in the second inning. The serve goes down. So in the second, no runs. One base hit, a double by Skarin. One man was left on, there were no errors. Score at the end of two innings of play now. It's Yankees nothing and Brooklyn nothing. Tommy Byrne comes to the mound now to start the third inning. He'll pitch to Zimmer, Padres, and Gilliam in that order. But before we get started, let's quickly pause for station identification. This is Mutual, the radio network for all America. Second baseman Don Zimmer coming up to the plate for his first at-bat of the afternoon, hitting number 8 in the Brooklyn order. He's had 2 base hits and 7 tries in the series, has driven in 2 runs, and he's batting at .286. Little right-hand hitter who holds a heavy bat way down to the end. He'll be followed by Johnny Padres, the pitcher, and then we'll go to the top of the batting order for Jim Gilliam. A scoreless duel here. We've had only game, the Yankees picked it up on Moose Garin's double in the second. So Tommy Burns gets ready now to begin inning number three. Burns sets, fires it in there, and the pitch is swung on, dragged across the carpet to short. Rizzuto off to his left, up with it, makes the throw to first in plenty of time, and Zimmer is out. One away, top of the third. Johnny Podres in the World Series this year has had one hit in three at-bats. So he's batting at 333. Johnny Podres getting the round of applause he richly deserves. Both of these pitchers have been old man ice water and old man tough this afternoon, right up to this minute. Podres standing in, about as deep in batter's box as law will allow. Bends over, Burns throws him the slider and gets it in there for a strike. No balls, one strike. One out, nobody on, top of the third, no score. Burns pumps, delivers, fastball, swung on and missed for strike two. Working right back to Podres on the 0-2 count. Throws a curveball. It's popped right back here by our cameras.